My name is Iain Couzin, and I'm fascinated by collective behaviour. It's all around us, bird flocks, fish schools. It's also within us, our body is a collective. And I study this at the University of Konstanz and the Max Planck Institute of Animal Behaviour. The fall of the Berlin Wall was an extraordinary event, seeing these two cultures that had been so isolated finally coming together. And I remember watching it with my family. I was about 15 at the time. Anytime society puts a wall like the Berlin Wall in between people, this breaks down collective action, this breaks down the ability for people to communicate effectively. By studying collectives, we've realized that intelligence isn't just in the brain, it's also in the network of communication, this invisible network of interactions among individuals. And a real barrier in the past has been, how on earth can we see the invisible? We have developed new technologies that allow us to get extremely detailed information about how animals behave, but also how they perceive each other and how they utilize that information to make decisions at the individual level, but also how this leads to widespread collective intelligence among the members of the group, an intelligence that doesn't exist in the individual's brains, but in the network of communication among them. We needed to develop a range of technologies to track the motion of hundreds or thousands of individuals simultaneously, to reconstruct how they perceive the world and to understand how their brains process this complex information as they move through space. In doing so, what we discovered is that evolution has found the same principles of computation, the same principles of intelligence, both in this invisible network of communication within animal groups and in the brains of the animals themselves, the network of neurons. The science of collective behavior is central to many of the key challenges we face as a human society. How do we solve global problems like climate change while also resolving local and global conflicts? How can we harness the benefits of collective intelligence while avoiding the damage that can be caused by collective ignorance or collective inaction? The study of collective behavior is still in its infancy. We're just beginning to understand how we can put groups together to make smarter decisions. There are many pressing challenges ahead. What keeps me awake at night is I think there's a fundamental mathematical connection between how computation, how intelligence arises across nature. My hope for the future is that we can learn from animal collectives how to function and operate within our modern, high-tech human societies, to be more empathic to each other, to be more understanding, and to achieve a higher form of intelligence within our societies too.